definitely more about the logistics. You got to have the right time, get the right snow, the right weather. Physically, you got to feel right. It's not that you can just go up and bag these things any day or every day. It really is about the right time.
That's our sunshine and snow-covered peaks.
The snow's aligning itself. We got really good coverage, and it's really come in nice. So now I just need to get some clear weather and then physically be prepared and mentally be prepared for them. And these are lines I've been looking at for 15 years and still I haven't got them. We are also caught up in our busy lives. We are confined by concrete, technology, and endless schedules, cell phones, texting. It's the technology age. But there is still this primal need we share to connect with nature. It is more important than ever to make this effort to get out. Those that are committed to the steep life are intent on adventuring into the great outdoors. We seek an unmatched freedom in the mountains, balancing risk versus reward, and ultimately finding fulfilling respect for the world around us.
Every direction I can see is bluebird, 100 miles out to the Gulf.
Since 1991, Dean has been pioneering regions in the Chugach Range of Alaska, sharing innovative lines for all skiers and snowboarders who are passionate about the mountains. Since he was a child, Dean knew growing up he wanted to make a living in the mountains.
I grew up in the mountains in New Mexico, and it was an amazing place because I had lots of opportunities to experience, you know, remote mountains and incredible places. It was pretty neat. There was Explorer Post where we went and rafted the Grand Canyon, and there was even in Boy Scouts we went and climbed 14,000 foot peaks in Colorado, so those opportunities were pretty amazing.
It was somewhere around that time, Dean realized he could foster an entire career out of and through the commitment to the steep life. This is when his desire became a goal.
When I first got to Alaska, I realized this place was huge. No one had ever really been and trained like this, and it really was a whole nother arena, and we just knew that it was all about developing the protocols, assessing from the top down. Being in the right place, having safe zones, being able to assess on the go. That's how it all started in the early years, was pioneering all that terrain, came right down to protocols.
In the early years, guiding and aviation were separate. Pilots would often drop them off in unexpected places, and it would take the skiers hours to get back to the road alive.
Dean Cummings from Santa Fe, New Mexico, is a core skier whose life revolves around the love of big mountains. When we turned Dean loose with a little heli time in Alaska, he skied lines like this.
See, I think you're gonna have to find out the lobby. Oh, yeah.
I mean, our clients were the best skiers in the world. They were extreme skiers. They expected the steepest, meanest, scariest peaks. And so we had to develop a whole set of protocols to be able to do that. And assessing from the top down it changes things. And so it all became about the route and group team emphasis and being visual and verbal with one another so you could communicate and change the plan if you needed to.
The protocols in the early years were all about terrain management. But those same protocols that were created more than two decades ago are so practical that anyone can implement them into their own mountain endeavors today.
I wanted to set up some practical protocols that were easy to implement that allowed me to be visual and verbal with my clients. The most important five things is number one, picking routes that allow you to go safe zone to safe zone. Picking routes that allow you to go and be visual and verbal with your clients or your partners. Number three, to do on-the-go snow assessment from a safe place. Number four, to have an exit so you don't have to commit to the concave, the convex, or the broad, wide-open slope. And the most important, number five, is to work from the apex or work from apex to apex. If it's group dynamics, you need to take into account how far, how steep, or how deep you're willing to go based on their ability, how well do you know them, how much experience do they have in the backcountry, and what kind of risk you're willing to take when you're out there. When it comes to stability, you need to take into consideration slope structure. You need to avoid the concave, convexes, terrain traps, unsupported slopes. You need to pick routes that allow you to be visual and verbal and go from safe zone to safe zone.
We're in safe zone down about 400 feet below the last one. If this route is going to work, this would be incredibly good powder, soft snow. But if we head into the tube, you know what that's like. So it's a change-up, be ready for that. Don't come in so hot. When you come off with soft snow, just cut over. We'll regroup and then we'll have to get back out on it.
Terrible wind here.
I put the furthest right track in, and I want you guys to ski left of my track. Stack left of my track. Nice. Come on in here.
In the winter of 2011, Dean wanted to knock off three first ascents in the Chugach Range. The opportunity presented itself for meteorite.
You know, a big descent like this takes a lot of preparing and looking at the weather, the snowpack, being physically fit, mentally ready, and then you gotta have the right day. And so you head up and you're going in the mountains with a 1, 2, and 3 strike rule. And so be it, these are big, bad descents. So they already have a strike against them as far as the danger associated with it.
So we're gearing up right now. We got our pilot with us. This is Vince. We got Trevor, one of the guides, and Eric Layton, one of the guides. And of course, Thomas and Jorge. So we're gonna go up and team up and document this descent. It's gonna be a pretty steep descent. It's pretty wild and definitely has its hazards. We just got about 10 feet of snow in the range over a 2-day period, 3 days ago. And so this is a really good opportunity. So physically, mentally, this is the time to go hit this thing. So we're gonna go piece it together and document it as well so we can share it. So it's gonna be a pretty neat day.
But in this case, I'm hoping just to go up with a strike one, big, mean descent that has a lot of risk.
if anything comes along as a strike too, then it's time to go home or just go ski some slopes for fun, go guide some people down some beautiful mountains. So when you're standing on a peak and you're looking down your line, there's nothing quite like it. You're about to commit to a serious slope. It's a full body experience. Once you leave the ridge, the safety of the ridge, that you're 10 feet below the ridge on a 55, 60 degree slope. It's not as easy as saying, stop, hold everything, let me hike back up. It really is. You're on it. The risk is there. Your senses just go to a whole new level.
Trevor, you ready? Dropping in 5 seconds.
No nonsense, really. I took a look into the tube. I sloughed it out to see how the slough would run.
Slough gel loader.
The helicopter was in the air, already getting ready to film. I got out on the main face, on the top crux, and I just took it right down the prow, right on the spine as it went off that beak of the fracture line. And took it right over the east side exposure. Really, really nice. It was a little punchy, little rotted out snow because it was shallow. Didn't want to catch a rock and trip on it, or do a kick out a small release. It was really rotten snow in that area. But I pieced it together really nice. I was really happy with how I made it through there. And did this double turn and let it go. Got on the spine and it just opened up 1,000 verticals of the biggest, most amazing spine you could ride on. Every other turn on my left turns, I was just white room. Down to the prow, it just goes 50 and just starts getting steeper. 51, 52, 53.
At this point, Dean was past the point of no return, committed himself to the 60 degree prow.
I stopped, I had my tips hanging off the east side and my tails hanging off the west side, and it was heaven. It was, the safest place you could ever want to be on the apex. Nothing could get you.
Let me get some breath. Let me prepare for this one.
I rested for a bit, got some oxygen in my blood, and started piecing together the 60 degree prow. and I was able to actually get down it pretty quickly. Did a friction slide on the left. It was just really steep, 60-ish more. But the snow was really good on the left side.
Like the skis just become an extension of your body. It's like they have nerves. You feel every little ice crystal, every little hard spot.
Got through there and came out really hot. It just seemed like a GS run down below, even though it's a pretty cool spine still. It's catching air off into the meteorite face, and got down, skied all the way to the bottom of the spine.
After completing the long-awaited Dragon's Back, the spine and soul of meteorite, Dean headed back down to meet his clients for a full day of guiding.
When I saw it yesterday, I just knew that it was the day to do it. Just, it was all there, everything was clean, it felt good, stability was nice. Slough was reasonable, it wasn't too bad, it was just pulling away from me off both sides, so that's the beauty of a spine. It's 2,800 vertical feet down the spine, so I'm trying to conserve my energy and make sure I could still have good strength through the crux moves, through some of the tighter technical zones. That was probably the most important part of the descent, was just really focusing on my breathing and my muscles and making sure I didn't give up too much in one place, so I had enough energy for both. The weather was there, the team was amazing, and it was just a great time to get it.
A couple weeks after meteorite, the conditions presented themselves to take a look at the tusk.
Preparing for the tusk was definitely humbling. I knew that getting off the top of that peak was going to be difficult.
Getting ready to head up to the tusk to take a look and see if we can descend it from the summit. Something I've looked at for many years and always wanted to do, so we'll see if we can't get it.
That's my main concern at this point, is just the rappel. And then the snow looks good. I'll just take it easy on the snow and be really cautious there.
The conditions were right, but time and execution was critical. The sun was setting, it was getting dark, and temperatures were dropping. If there were any errors, it could be a long night on the mountain.
The flight into the tusk was definitely scary. I knew that as soon as I stepped out of the helicopter, I was on my own. And it was late. I was knew if anything happened, I'd be bivvying out for the night. And it just built it all up. I just really went into my own head and really had to just make sure it was something I was willing to do, because I knew once I stepped out of that helicopter, I couldn't rely on it. And if anything went wrong, I knew I was going to bivvy out. And if I was injured, I knew nothing could happen till the next day.
Thank you.
As I started to rappel, the first 25 feet was just going off about a 40-foot block of rock to get to the very edge. Couldn't see anything of the mountain or the rappel below going down to it. And I knew that, you know, if anything would happen, like a rock coming out, dislodging, hitting me in the head, that would have been a serious situation. It would have been hard for anybody to help me at that point. And I also knew that I had to steer the rope into the sweet spot, into the places where the rock wasn't so sharp. And that was challenging. That took a lot of footwork. I ended up rappelling down and working against the rope to my left. So I steered the rope into the, you know, away from sharp areas and into smooth areas. And so I steered the rope and I made sure it laid into the sweet spot in many places. The footwork and the amount of leg strength and the energy I burned doing that was a lot greater than I expected. I got down to the snow. It was, I don't know, around 60, 70 degrees at first. I chose not to unhook from the rope at that point. I wanted to go down a little bit further to feel out the snow, the stability. The upper pitch is an unsupported slope, which means there's nothing holding it from the bottom up, and it's up there in the wind and getting a lot of loading off the arete to the east. So I rappelled down another 40, 50 feet on the rope before I unhooked.
On rappel, Dean worked against the rope for 220 feet. He used more energy than expected. He had to catch his breath down on the snow, but he knew the sun was setting fast on the apron. Every turn was crucial as darkness closely followed.
Quite a few number of turns on that 60 degree, which is really hard to do, but in this case it just felt really good and really comfortable. My instincts were definitely telling me that it was all about making those turns to work down. And what I had to do is I had to get down to like this little double fall line wind wave cornice. And it went, you know, 60 degrees, and then I had to drop in. On that was about 80 degrees of a double fall line to get onto this little patch of snow above a small cliff and a bunch of rocks. And then from there, you know, I just wanted to ski. I let it go. Made it to the spine in about four turns. Got on the spine, and that's where it just felt so nice. You know, you're just on the apex, the high point. If anything were to slide, it would part around me. Just a wonderful place to be. And then I'd get back out onto the face, into the runnels and flutes. And, you know, the thing didn't let up the whole way to the bottom. It definitely was challenging. After I came down onto the glacier off the Tusk, it was the most rewarding feeling. Definitely the most rewarding feeling I've ever had coming off a big descent. It was dark. I looked back up the peak and it was this purple midnight blue color, and I could see my tracks faintly, and I just was so in heaven at the time. And I finally got off the summit that I'd been trying to get for so many years. It was a very rewarding day.
After 20 years in the making of research and attempts, the Tusk and Meteorite had finally presented themselves. The conditions were right, and Dean was rewarded with two of the three target first descents. But as the snow aligns and covers the Chugach with another 100 plus feet of snow, the drive, passion, and commitment will be on top, pointing down again this season.